So how you gonna all these? I ain't got no brothers. Are you crazy? You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You got 8 brothers. How many sisters I got? All these sisters? I ain't got no family. What's the matter with you? You need to loosen up. You in the family? What? You got all these sisters? You got all these sons? You got all these daughters? That's why you can't do certain things, because look at all your daughters. So that becomes your glory. Come on, raise your hand and love the Lord. Yeah, you're always being watched. All we got to do is drop a dime. And one of these brothers holler and say, man, the man, look here, just like in the scripture, man, they didn't roll up on and took my woman and run off with her, and she trying to get back to me. They got a hell hostage here. They call all us, man. We got trucks. We're going to blow our horns. Come on, praise him. We done. We're going to drive away. We're going to turn our lights on. He don't know what we got inside. Let chastity go. All you got to do is call us. Say, he got me hemmed up in here. He's hurting my heart. Call us. Come on, praise him. I'm done. Your problem, you're going to try to handle it all yourself. I just didn't know what to do. Call your brother. I guarantee if I was in a situation and I called you, and you, and said, I need your help. I got this woman up here. She's trying to jack me. Y'all would ride on her. Y'all would, oh, man. Stand on your feet. Let's praise the Lord. You, my brother and sister, take somebody by the hand. That's why if you stink, it's on all us. I know you got gang. I see you. Got a gangster wife, too. Some of y'all used to fight. I didn't know you in the streets, but I know you. When God told me, that one. So spiritually, when you feel you uncovered, listen to me, darlings. When you feel you uncovered, you being attacked, that means you vulnerable and you stinking. God knows. But if you see how he handled it, he sent Joab and an army. You can't go through it by yourself. You're going to have to drop some of that pride. I ain't say you're going to call a brother up and just all in your personal business. But you need to realize that ain't no man going to hurt you physically. There shouldn't be a woman in here. I'm being abused. Somebody beat me up. Are you crazy? Amen. We ain't coming into your house, but you can't nobody stop us from coming to your street and parking in front of your house. And all you got to do is open the door. Now, look. That's one day he going to think about that beating. He said, look, well, who's that Jag out there? And who's that 300 out there? And who's that Ram, that Dodge Ram? Who's driving that white Ford? Who's all these? You sleeping with these fools? Who is this? Get your wig on, let him know. You know what he met with? Get your good wig. Put your good wig on. Put it on straight. Don't put it on backwards. Just say to him, look here. Just let you know. Come on. He going to think about that next one. That's your problem. Am I right about it? You let her call a bunch of y'all on me, man. I'm going to say, yeah, brother, what is it that you want? Come on, praise the Lord. Come on, praise the Lord. Come on. Now, love somebody. Love somebody. Love somebody. Look at somebody. Say, the joy of the Lord is my strength. Say, we family. Come on out here. Come on out here, ministers, pastors. Y'all stand out here. We got them back in the booth over there, man. Don't they look good over there? Don't they? Give them a hand. Give them a hand. Give them a hand. They ain't used to being out there. They used to being out here with y'all, but they over there. They ain't in timeout, so don't look at them like that. But come on, we're going to have a quick little prayer. I want you to pray for somebody. Pray some love on them. Yeah, my daughter Shauna, too, shoot. And all these, man, I got all kinds of daughters. You got all kinds of brothers. And we don't want to lose nobody. I said the other day, the Lord showed me that sometimes people move around because if they want to stay in something, I'm the first person sometimes they're going to point their fingers at. But if y'all don't know by now that I love you, you ain't going to never know it. And the rest of them love you too, but I love you. I love you enough to tell you the truth because I ain't scared of you. There ain't no fear in love. That's what the Bible says. And I was telling Sister Conley, because I was talking to somebody the other day, and they were telling me, I appreciate our praise team and what they're doing. Y'all need to celebrate them. Thank God for Brother Ramon and the drummer. But Brother was telling me on Thursday, he was telling me, he said, Pastor, you know why I appreciate you? I've always appreciated you, but he said, you know why I really appreciate you? And it ain't about me, but he done something when he told me this. He encouraged me. He said, because there was a time I was at your church and you was ministering and you just told the truth out loud without calling anybody's name, which I can imagine doing that for. But he said it was about the praise team. And he said, I think something was going on, which I don't know. You know, something always go on in that department in a good way. Well, I mean, you know, that's Satan's alma mater. You know, like some of y'all is Kappas. That's where he comes from. He got his own science, he flashed. But anyway, he said, but you spoke the truth, and him being a musician, he said, and that blessed me because the truth that you said was transparent. Well, I told him, I said, man, I ain't trying to hurt nobody, but you know what? Where I give God glory is that they was men and women enough to handle it and not, you know, yeah, they probably had, yeah, you need to celebrate. They probably had some wounds they need to lick. Probably said, that'll be always, somebody, yeah, he said, you put them on blast. And I'm like, man, I sometimes, because I walk in revelation, if I pray and worship, God will give me stuff that I know. Sometimes he give me direct stuff, and sometimes he just give it to me, and I know it's stepping on people. And so if I do it that way, it saved me from having to call you out and put you in a position to lie to me. Now you doing this and that. I ain't doing that, and then go tell everybody. So I just preach the truth. Just preach the truth. If the shoe fit, wear it. Because some people ain't spiritual enough to respect me or honor me. The position, Pastor, the position. Like these pastors, the position. We don't walk on water. We ain't got nothing that God didn't give us. But just like me, they got gifts. And if they get and when they get and God does and he will do more, there's certain things that will come out of their mouth. They may not all do it from here because everybody ain't called to here. They may get a word from you and want to call you after church. You can't be rebuking them. I only hear it from the great apostle. I'm asleep. Out eating, watching the game, playing with my puppy. They told you. Y'all worked that out. But when he told me that, it just blessed me because not so much I see it, but because these people who have weathered could handle truth. Got a revelation one time about the team. Oh, I see it now. The Lord showed me they had a tambourine and they was in the desert, man. They were stomping. Dust was coming up. And the Lord just says, keep on preaching because, no, they're not being celebrated now. No, they're in a dry place. But they were stomping in the desert. spirit wouldn't let him quit. Might have got rebuked. Might have felt like, why didn't he talk to me special? I don't know why. But they didn't give up on God. So I want to see some more doves. I want to see some signs and wonders. And we're going to activate y'all's gifts. We're going to activate them. All right? But we're going to pray. And let Omniplex come on or whatever. Omnicron, come on. We're going to march through it. We'll still put a tent up. They ain't got no disease to stop Shepherd Fold Ministry as long as Jesus Christ is on the throne. I wish I had an amen from somebody. We'll Zoom if we have to, but we'll do it in the parking lot. We'll do it in the field. Let them cough, but we ain't dead. And ain't none of us going to die till the rapture comes. I thought about your mama the other day, driving that big old white deuce in the quarter, or Oldsmobile or something, man, with them sunglasses on, and had a gold, didn't you have gold teeth in her mouth? That was the other woman, McAfee.
Yeah, that
wasn't
her.
That, you know the woman I'm talking about? And she lived till she was 90, didn't she? Come on, somebody. I thought, I don't know, I keep thinking that's your mama. But you know, she was your mother in the spirit. She was that kind of woman. She was 90 years old, man. And if you was riding down the road, she'd come up behind you in that big old white Cadillac, beep on you two times, get out the way. I'm 90 years old, and I got somewhere to go. And she did it to the day they took her out of here. Y'all need to come on, let's live. I'm going to raise your hand. Let's celebrate these people.
Hallelujah.
Let's celebrate these people.
Hallelujah.
Let's celebrate them.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want you to love and respect them.
Glory.
Celebrate them.
Glory.
Celebrate the woman over there.
Hallelujah.
Celebrate one another.
Glory.
Come on.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
All right. God bless you. Now listen, we're going to need all you members to sign the member roster, so we can get your birthdays, your anniversaries, you know, the day of your children or whatever. So we won't have to do that. You know, we can't do it for everybody. Excuse me. But we want to recognize you. We want to try to do it another way because God's getting ready to give us supernatural growth. And in our new time, we're going to be getting you out a little bit early. I know I went over, but I got a little time. I'm trying to work on it, trying to work on it. But God ain't about our protocol either. We're going to get delivered.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. So, sister, I don't know, did you bring it today? Okay, get it today. Get it today. We got a baptism. Those of you have to go. You're going to be dismissed here in a minute. But I want you to sign. I want every member to sign. So we can do it right, put it in the computer, have FedEx bring you a puppy or something on your birthday. I liked you, man. I thought you liked puppies. Oh, God. You lost some points. Okay, you like puppies? Yeah, you got a puppy. All right. All the puppy lovers, raise your hand. My kind of people. Lynn, I didn't know that about you. Ross, where your hand at, darling? Pray for the pastor that they would love puppies. Crystal love puppies, so yeah, she got him. Oh, gonna be friction in your house like it's in mine. I love my angels, and man, my wife can't stand angels. But when angels go, I go. She's still outside. Angel need to go. Where angel go, I go. We'll handle this at home. We don't bring our business to church. I bring angel up in here and say, we'll shut this down. I'm so happy today. Hey, y'all, when Gigi, y'all hit up, man, just say, hey, good job. Trust me. I'll send you some stuff out, but she done an awesome job. It's just awesome, man. And there were others. Done an awesome job, you know, a lot of pastors down there, went to Dallas, but just let's love on her, amen, that's all you got to do, but she did, just trust me, she did a good job, and I'm going to send you some video. Okay. Okay, well, I got better stuff, you know. But I didn't get everything she did. She sang in the night. But they would have two or three people singing. And, man, they had some people. All of them was just awesome. And it's just that sometimes when you get away from home and you get around strangers, you can just go ahead and kind of let God use you. And I'm praying that for all of you who are ministering in song. I wouldn't be ashamed, any of y'all, to go somewhere and represent for the kingdom because I know you're real. But anyway, I just want to tell you, our sister did a good job. She represented the kingdom good. So just hit her up when she get back or whatever. Yeah. And we're gonna get a bucket up here and start a puppy farm. So let's pray. Let's pray. Or kittens. No kittens. No kittens. Okay. Don't you think Pastor Robinson need an animal other than a goldfish? The Lord said, get you the goldfish, but I think I hear Saint Bernard. No. Okay, let's pray. Come on. Pastor Robinson, you go ahead and let us go.
We bless you, Jesus. Emma Saba Kondriko. Sambaliko.
We love you, Jesus. In Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Hey, and whose birthday is it? Okay, let's go. Oh, well, my birthday? Seven.
Go ahead and sing. One, two, three.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.